हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, गुड आफ्टरनून, वेलकम बैक टू मैथमेटिक्स सेशन। वी आर डिस्कसिंग यूनिट 5, दैट इज टाइम, राइट? यस। इन टाइम व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड, वी हैव सीन कैलेंडर, वी हैव सीन कैलेंडर एंड वी लर्नड डेज एंड मंथ्स, राइट? हाउ मेनी डेज आर देयर? 7 days are there in a week. How many months? How many months are there in 1 year? 12 months. So, 1 week will have 7 days. 1 month will have 30 days. 1 year will have 12 months. And 1 year will have 365 days. And what is leap year? Leap year is like February month. We'll have 29 days once in 4 years, right? So every time we'll have 28 days in February month, but in leap year we'll have 29 days. So in leap year we'll have 366 days in total. Okay, so you all learned this one, right? Next, see this one. A year has 365 days, right? There are 7 days in a week, right? There are 7 days in a week. 12 months are 1 year. 12 months make 1 year. A month has 30 days. A first month of a year is, first month of a year is January. First day of a week is Sunday. Right? Okay. Now, next thing what we have learned, we have seen 2018 calendar and we have did this exercise in Zoom classes and in the last class also. So, Teacher's Day is on September 5. Independence Day, August 15. Republic Day is on January 26. Children's Day is on November 14. Right? And then, we did match the following also. See here, November 15, 2018. So November means which month it will come? January is 1, February is 2. In that way, November will be 11. So 15-11-2018. Next, June. June month is 6. So, 16-6-2018. Next, April. April is 4. 26-4-2018. Next, December. December is 12. 10-12-2017. Next, May. May is 5. 26-5-2017. Right? We have discussed this in Zoom class and in the last class also, right? Okay. Next thing, what we have seen, there is one calendar, that is October 2018 calendar, and they have asked few questions. So, looking into this calendar, we have to answer this blanks, right? So, first one, number of days in October 2018, how many days are there? 31. See, last number is 31. So, 31 days. Number of Sundays. See here. 7, 14, 21, 28. These all are Sundays. How many are there? 4 are there. So, 4. The first Saturday is on. Where is the Saturday? Here, Saturday. So, first Saturday is on 6th. Right? 6th. Last day of the month is. So, 31 is the last day. And what is the day? See, Wednesday, okay. Next, the 10th day of this month is, see the 10th, yes, 10th. So, 10th day of this month is again Wednesday. Next, the 3rd Wednesday comes on, 3rd Wednesday. 3 is 1st, 10 is 2nd, so 3rd is 17, right, 17, yes. So, we have discussed, finished about calendar. Now the next topic is manufacture and expiry date. Manufacture and expiry date. What is this manufacture? Manufacture means, see, for example, we are buying one soap. Okay, so when that soap was manufactured, when they made the soap, okay, whether in 2017 or 2018, 2019 or 2020, okay, in which year and which month, January, February or December, whatever the month, okay, and which date. So we should know the manufacture date as well as expiry date. What is expiry date again? Expiry date means EXP date, that is the date until the soap we can use until the date. After that we should not use any product, okay, we should never use beyond the expiry date, okay. So for example, see this is honey bottle. So the manufacture date, MFG means manufacture, when this honey was made was 13/11/2017. So 13th November 2017 they made this honey, okay. Now what is the expiry date? Expiry date is 4/4/2019, 4th of April 2019 it expires, means after this date we should not use this honey, okay, even this medicine also, soap also. See, soap manufacture date is 10/12/2017, expiry date is 9/3/2019. So after March 9th 2019 we should not use this soap. So always whenever you buy any products in the market, we have to see the manufacture date as well as expiry date, okay. So see, the back side will have manufacture date, MFG date and EXP date like this. So you have to check the EXP date as well as manufacture date before buying any product. Any product, if you go to the supermarket and if you buy, you just check it down and buy, because some people they will sell the expired products, okay, already that expiry date will be finished for that products, so they will be selling, and which is very harmful for us. So we should not use that products after expiry date, okay. After expiry date means that is expired means dead, okay. So the product is dead, okay, we should not use that product after the death date, okay children. So we should always check with manufacture date and expiry date. So to make you understand what is that and how you have to teach others about this one, they have given few exercises, okay. See, the first one is biscuit packet. So they have asked the manufacture month or date. So manufacture month is 17/2019. What is the expiry month? See, it is 12 months it is there, 12 months, okay. So within 12 months you have to use this, okay. The same way, see this packet. So this has given 11/18. 11 means November 2018 is the manufacture date, and here 10/20, so October 20 expiry date, okay. The same way this one also, 28/7/2012 is the manufacture, 28/7/2017 is the expiry date, okay. See the answers I have given here, okay. If possible you just write your own, okay. Seeing this one you write, try to do this, okay children. Okay, the next one, see the next one. See, they have asked calculate duration between manufacture and expiry date of the products. So here are few products: honey, cashew nut, pickle, coffee powder, badam milk, okay. These are the few food products and this is the manufacture date for these products, okay. Honey is manufactured in 2017 and expiry date also they have given here. So we have to find the difference. Different means how many years difference is there. For example, 2017 2019, so how many years? It is 2 years difference, okay. like that we have to find. See, I have given the answers. The honey will have 2 years, 2 months in this. Okay, and cashew nut will have 3 years, 2 months. Okay, pickle will have just 2 months, February 2018 to April 2018. Okay, coffee powder. See, coffee powder is 3 months. Badam milk. See, February to March, only 1 month. Okay, so we should see this manufacture and expiry dates, and we have to buy the products. Okay, so will you see it, few things in your house, few products, whichever you want, like butter you will have in the house, milk you will have, whatever. Okay, just whatever it is there, you just see and do this as an assignment. See here, fill up the date of manufacture and date of expiry of food products you use in daily life. Okay, daily life, whatever you see in your house. So name of the food products in this column, manufacture date and expiry date. So any 5, okay, Amul butter or anything, biscuits, whatever, chocolates, any product, you just write the product name here, the manufacture date. See back side of that product. If you have chocolate in your house, just see, turn back the chocolate packet and you can find out like this bar. Okay, one bar shape you will find like this. Okay, one white color. Okay, like this you can have it. So see there and then find out what is the manufacture date and then what is the expiry date. Okay, will you do this? Yes, do this and send me through WhatsApp. Okay children. Okay, with this we have finished our 5th lesson. Okay, so let's start 6th lesson and we'll have a short discussion about 6th lesson. Okay, so 6th lesson, that is a new lesson and the last lesson in mathematics first term. Okay, so 6th lesson is information processing. What is that unit 6 name? Information processing. Okay, so what is this big lesson? Oh, you're this much big name is, what is this? You just don't think this is very easy lesson because it is full of like whatever we are seeing in day-to-day life, the full thing is discussed in this lesson. Okay children, so information, only the name is big. Okay, name is big but not the lesson. Okay, information processing. Okay, now I'll show you one thing. See here, how many trousers are there? 2 trousers are there, one is yellow and one is green. How many shirts are there? Only one shirt here, purple color, and here pink color. So yellow, purple, pink. So 2 trousers are there and 2 trousers are there and 3 shirts are there. Okay, so one boy named Kevin. Okay, Kevin has 2 trousers and 3 shirts with him. Okay, he bought this to picnic, it seems. Okay, now how can he wear this thing? He don't have 3 trousers, only 2 trousers he is having, but he has 3 shirts. How he will wear? Okay, this lesson is about distributing. Okay, distributing. Okay, let's see. See here, here, see, yellow color shirt, yellow color trouser, yellow color shirt, yellow color, green color trouser. Next, pink color shirt, see, yellow color trouser, pink, green color trouser. Purple, yellow color trouser, purple, green color trouser. See how many days? Actually he is having 3 shirts, so he can wear only 3 days, but how many days he is wearing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 days he is wearing with only 3 shirts. Understood? So 6 days he is wearing different, with different trousers, right? So this type of sharing, okay, this type of sharing or distribution, okay, this type of sharing or distribution, distributing, okay, this thing is called, we'll discuss in this type of things, we'll discuss in this unit, that is information processing. Okay, so we'll see one more example. Yes, see here, Kavya is having one apple and one orange. Okay, one apple and one orange. And in vegetable session, she is having one carrot and one cucumber. One carrot she is having and one cucumber she is having. So, she want to combine daily. Like daily she want to eat one fruit and one vegetable. Okay. So, she want to eat one fruit and one vegetable only. So, like that she want to eat on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So, how she can distribute this one? See. First Monday she ate apple and carrot. Second day she ate apple, cucumber. Third day, orange, carrot. Fourth day, orange, cucumber. Understood, children? Very easy, right? That's why I said in the beginning, only the name of the lesson is big, but it will be very easy inside. Right? Very easy. Right? See the next one. See here, this is coloring. You can do it very nicely. Okay? So, here red, blue, okay. So, you have to find all the possible ways of coloring. You have to use only red, blue, red color and blue color, and you have to color differently, okay, not the same way. This pattern should not repeat, okay. Next one, you color like this, blue, red, okay. And the next one, blue, red. Okay, next one, red, blue. Okay, children, like the differently you have to color fully. Okay, understood? Can you do this? Yes, do this and show me, okay? Okay, next one. See here, they have given these blocks. See here, blocks are there. Okay, first one, pink. See here, white came here, green, different they have given, right? So, seeing this block, we have to answer these questions. Okay. So, total number of blocks. How many are there total number of blocks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, 10 blocks are there. Number of rose block. Rose means pink. 1, 2, 3. 3 are there. Number of green blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 are there. Right? 4 blocks are there. Next, number of rose blocks in second and fourth row. Second row 1, fourth row 2. So, total 3 are there. How many green blocks more than pink? How many are there? See, green are 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, pink are only 1, 2, 3. So, how many are extra? 1 is extra. Okay, children. So, see the answers. It should be like this. See, you have to write it like this. First one is 10, 3, 4, 3, 1. Okay, very easy, no? The questions will be like this only. Don't worry, okay? Okay, children. See the next one. Next one, we are collecting and representing data. Okay, here one picture is there. So, in this session, we'll see different types of pictures. Seeing the pictures, we have to answer the questions. Okay. See here, these are all are lions. This is one big train. And in the first one, what is there? This is lions. Okay. What is that? Lions. Next one, tigers. Next one, monkeys. Next is elephant. Next is deer. Okay. Okay. See. First question, seeing this full pictorial representation means pictures, okay. So, seeing the pictures, you have to answer. So, how many lions are there? See, 1, 2, 3, 3 lions. How many monkeys are there? 1, 2, 3, 3 monkeys. Circle the animal which is more in count. So, here 4, 5 are there. What? Tigers. So, circling, tiger. Next, circle the animal which is less in count. Only 2 elephants are there. So, circling. What is the difference between highest and lowest count? Highest and lowest count. What is the difference? See here, 5 are there and here 2 are there. So 5 minus 3, 5 minus 2, 3. Okay, difference means minus. Total number of animals in the zoo. Zoo train is, see here, 3, 3 plus 5, 3 plus 5, 8, 8 plus 3, 11, 11 plus 2, 13, 13 plus 4, 17. So total 17. So in like this, we have to see the pictures and we have to answer the questions. Okay, children, very easy, no? Sixth lesson will be very easy. Okay, children, I hope you all understood. In the next session, we'll discuss more about sixth lesson. Okay, children, do the assignment and send me through WhatsApp. Okay, thank you.